This team has a 70% win ratio, 72% if you want to be exact. This is the Brazilian team that has been helping me climb in ELO. I dropped like crazy, so I decided to start using the team that works for me. If a team works for you, honestly suggest using that same team. Honestly, for the most part, I only got a worst case scenario. I got one set where it was a 2 out of 5, and maybe that was also because I did some misplays. But other than that, this team is super strong. It's very well built. I think that's something that I've noticed. But anyway, let's get on to these battles. We got Virizion, Walrein, Charizard. And if you guys haven't already, make sure to leave a like and also consider subscribing, especially if you like Pokemon Go content. Right here, we've swapped out to our Walrein. Well, obviously because our Charizard went down. So I don't know if we honestly win this. I'm going to go ahead and show some of the losses as well. I don't want to just show all the wins. I think for this set, it's 3 out of 5. So it's 18. So out of 5 sets, I got 18 out of 25. 18 wins out of 25 battles. So yeah, I definitely don't win this one. I was trying to align things as best as I can. The only real big concern is when you're going up against Giratina. And I was swapping Charizard into Giratina. But honestly, what I've noticed, if you swap in your Walrein, I know it's the hard counter to Giratina, but if you swap in the Walrein, you'll have a higher chance of winning, of taking back the match, as opposed to you swapping to a Charizard. Just something that I've noticed. I've come very close to some wins, and you'll actually end up seeing them. I still do lose, but I think it was because of some mistakes, so my opponents played very well. Let's move on to the next match. We got Virizion against Poliwrath. This is an amazing lead. This is exactly what you want to see. But for the most part, the main swap will honestly be Walrein. That will be the safe swap of this team. So I ended up, I think, maybe farming a little bit over and then decided to throw the move. I'm thinking maybe he was going to swap out, but he doesn't. I do end up shielding a Power Punch, which was really annoying. So I'm thinking, is he Power Punch Ice Punch? I was really unsure. And I'm going to go ahead and shield this. I'm thinking it's probably going to be another pup. But he reveals it's actually Scald. And now we can go ahead and switch in our Walrein. And this is why I'm telling you this team is built so well around. Because when your opponent decides to safe swap a Giratina, we got the Walrein in the back ready for it. So in this case, we're both down a shield each. So this is looking pretty good. I do allow them, we do win CMP, which is really good. So this is going to be more than enough to be able to take it out. And now they're going to go ahead and I do have a little bit more energy. So I'm hoping whatever comes in, let's see if we can get to move. Turns out they're going to bring in a Lapras. So going to go for the big damage, going to go up. Well, obviously I need to go for this big move because they're going to resist the Icicle Spears. And I'm thinking, can I actually reach another, earthquake? Now, I do have some pretty good IVs on this Walrein, and they end up catching on their Poliwrath, but honestly, it's not the catch that they wanted to, and here's where I make my mistake. I figured they were energy dry, so I'm swapping on my Charizard. Might have been safer. It would have been a lot safer to do the Virizion, but I was going with the strategy that I needed to preserve as much health as possible on the Virizion, and Lapras isn't known to be the hardest hitter. So we took that serve like a champ, and we actually end up taking the match with the Charizard. Moving on to the next one, we got Virizion against an Ambrose. This is exactly what you want to see. I swear, yesterday, it was all Giratina leads. All Giratina leads. Probably if you had an Obstagoon or a Walrein, you were like doing really good. They actually threw. Now, I did try to count it, and I'm like, it got to like 4 of like the... I don't know, honestly, I don't know what the fast move is, but it got to like 4. And then right here, actually, I think it was 4 as well. I apologize, probably I'm not even really counting good as I'm commentating here. But I went over as much as I could because I'm like, they're allowing me to get a lot of farm here. And they might have thought I had Stone Edge possibly. They probably lost track, who knows. Now that I think about it, that's probably why they shielded. I'm like, why did they shield? But this is really good for us because now we're up 2 shields. I'm going to bring in the Charizard. Now, I think I actually shield this first one, and then I do mess up here. This is where I mess up, guys. I should have just thrown that Dragon Claw right there. I think that might have been enough to take it out. So I messed up and I'm like, I'm not even gonna use a shield. They decide to bring in a Swampert. What I'm looking to do is I'm gonna catch this move. I'm looking to catch. Waiting till it gets to five. Right here, got to five. We're gonna go ahead and catch this Hydro Cannon. Let's freaking go. I'm sure they were probably annoyed at that point. And I could have honestly, we CMP here. I did mess up there. There's like this little bits and pieces. And I'm like, dude, that's an Earthquake? I had no idea it had gone up to that much energy. And I undercharged it a little bit because I want to be able to get to the big, I want to get to an Icicle Spear. And I'm able to get the last and final shield. Now I can't switch out just yet. Luckily, I have the Dragon Claw banked, but I'm like, dude, Typhlosion went CMP over Charizard? That honestly to me was very shocking and surprising. But let me know in the comment section if any of you guys knew that. This is the first time I've learned about that, unless there was lag and I couldn't click it on time, but I'm pretty sure that was CMP. So right here, this is what I'm talking about, guys. I'm gonna go stay swap the Walrein. They're gonna bring in their hard counter, but because I have Earthquake, it's gonna do a lot of damage. I don't bait in these matchups. I don't bait in these matchups when it comes to this. Now, I'm not gonna shield this one. They're gonna be dumping a lot of energy here. I'm gonna just let them use all their energy, and now I'm gonna farm down with Charizard. I could farm down, and this is when counting is very important because it takes six double kicks to get to the Stone Edge. Right here, I only counted four, and I was kind of second guessing myself, but I only counted four. Now they're gonna go ahead and reveal. I think it's a Walrein, right? So we're gonna go for the hard hitting move, but maybe I should have just stayed in with the Charizard because now they're gonna pair up the Giratina. So maybe I should have just, it's kind of up in the air, right? So Giratina leads will always be hard. I do have a bunch of energy on the Virizion, however. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just start, you know, doing the best I can. I think what I was trying to do is basically get to the point where I can hopefully maybe take it out with a Dragon Claw. But honestly, probably not the case. And I think I do mess up. I think I actually, the switch clock runs out and actually Charizard ends up taking a move. Watch what's going to happen. So they're gonna do this and I'm fine. They're going to take me out at this point. They're going to take me out. Couldn't get to the other move, sadly. And then I should have thrown that Dragon Claw. That probably costed me the match. That was really bad. So now I'm forced to like overthrow like crazy, right? So that honestly, losing that shield costed me the match because they're still up two shields, right? I could have won. I could have taken this match. So this is what I'm talking about, guys. You can still win the match even with the Giratina lead. You just have to play right. See, I was supposed to throw that Dragon Claw at that Giratina so I don't have to shield that move, right? But I ran out of shield, so I couldn't reach that third Dragon Claw that I was needed. So very, very badly played there. Now, up against a Haxorus, this is really good. You don't use any shields right here. You want to go ahead, as soon as you get to the first Sacred Sword, you want to throw it right away. Because you don't want to throw that attack once it's already been debuffed. Most of the time, they will always shield that first one. Now, once you get to the other one, throw it right away as well. Now, I think my opponent might have been, I don't know if they lagged or what happened there, but it actually allowed us to reach 1 HP in a dream and actually do this Sacred Sword here, which takes him out. So not only are we up a shield, but we're also winning switch. And now we can go ahead and align Pokemon the way we wanted to. I'm going to go ahead and bring in my Walrein. Looks like they're not switching out just yet. So I'm going to go ahead and use this Icicle Spear, which would take it out. They ended up shielding that. I'm like, okay. Let's go ahead and shield and find out what's in the back. And they end up doing a superpower. It's an Empoleon in the back. They're down a shield. So guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to do an Earthquake. But I need this Walrein still. So I'm going to go ahead and at this point shield this. Now I'm going to go ahead and bring in my Charizard. And I'm going to go ahead and Dragon Claw. And if you guys hear Pokedex, it's in the back of my daughter's right here playing. But we're going to take it out with Dragon Claw. And we're gonna be able to, because the Dragonite would be forced to throw. So we're able to reach a Dragon Claw and we just take it out from this point. And I believe that's the first set. So 3 out of 5 in this set. Moving on to the next set, we got a pretty solid lead. Now, they are doing super effective damage, but Virizion is gonna be able to outpace the Walrein. So this is a really, really good lead here. And normally what I do here is I shield this first one, and most of the time they don't shield. Most of the time they don't shield this next one. And I do still want to win switch in this case, so I get a lot of farm. I actually shield this, and honestly, maybe it's not too necessary. It should be able to bridge zone. It's pretty nice, so it should be able to live it. But I was glad that I shielded that, because look what happened. They're going to bring in a Cobalion. This was a huge mistake on their part, right? And I snuck in that double kick, which is going to be very helpful for us. They're going to do that Sacred Sword. We're both down shields. Need to do the Sacred Sword right here. Cobalion went CMP. And because of that, I'm glad we didn't CMP there. I snuck in that double kick originally, so it allows me to get to this. And we're able to take Cobalion, which our Walrein doesn't want to see. Neither does our Charizard. Right here, I'm not going to bring in Walrein because I believe that move, it's like counter or something, because it's super effective to the Walrein. I have to look up what that fast move is on Haxorus that's super effective in the Walrein. That's why I don't switch in the Walrein. Our opponent was trying to catch there, couldn't get it, so they can see the match. Moving on to the next one. What I do with Dragonite leads, I save swap the Charizard. In this case, that's when we don't save swap the Walrein. We bring in Charizard. We start threatening with the Dragon Claws. And something that I noticed, this isn't the first Shadow Dragonite that I face in the lead. I don't know why they're like two shielding everything. I'm going to go ahead and do another Dragon Claw. They did a superpower for whatever reason. I have no idea. So that was a huge misplay on their part. But I misplay right here. I should have known at this point that they're definitely going to try and catch. And they caught on a Cobalion, which was really annoying. I could have, if I was patient enough, which I was trying to be, I could have gotten that Blast Burn and made this match a whole lot easier than it had to be. Right here, I'm not going to shield this first one. I'm actually not looking to shield anything here. I'm going to go ahead and now just, I'm going to let this go. Now, I do end up messing up here. I do mess up here. I should have just been throwing it. Should have just been throwing it, because now I'm taking damage that I didn't need to get. I'm not going to shield this. You know, I messed up big time, but I think we're going to be okay. I'm going to do the Sacred Sword. Going to do the Sacred Sword. It ends up being a Charizard, okay? I'm going to have to now that I know what it is, I need to bring in my Walrein. We're a shield up. We're looking good, right? I'm going to throw, unfortunately, I throw at CMP. A lot of these matches I throw on CMP. Try your best not to do that. And I ended up shielding this Blast Burn. I was almost debating it because I know they're at a move. And I'm thinking, dude, please don't be a superpower. But Walrein is able to live a superpower even from a shadow at that range. So that opponent ended up conceding the match. It was very upset. Here is the other Haxorus lead that we have. Now, this one didn't work the same way as last time. I was thinking I'm able to get to that third move, but I'm actually not, and I'm playing the same way. They're going to do a Breaking Swipe. As soon as I get to this other move, I'm going to do the Sacred Sword. I think this opponent is throwing on good timing. That's probably what it is. Because see, now they're going to get to this other move, and I think my other opponent didn't throw it in time. I think that's what happened. So I'm like, why couldn't we reach it? Now, this is where I'm going to bring in my Charizard, and I'm going to farm down. Now, Breaking Swipe does a pretty good amount on Charizard, so I shield here. I'm going to go farm down, but they end up bringing a Politoed. So I'm going to go ahead and now bring in my Walrein. I'm thinking there's no way they have Earthquake. They end up having an Ice Beam, which leads me to think they're probably running that Weather Ball and then Ice Beam. So we're looking so good right now. We're looking so good. I'm going to go ahead and start doing these Earthquakes right here. And I'm going to go ahead and just, because, you know, Politoed is super tanky. I'm like, yeah, I'm not going to throw no Icicle Spear. That makes no sense. But I am going to be over farming a lot, though, you know, because we're taking these like a champ. And at that point, now they're going to swap into Poliwrath. And I'm going to go ahead and now bring my Charizard. I have so much energy on this Poliwrath. But it also makes me forget that they still have a Politoed. I'm going to need to shield this because more than likely this is going to be Scald. Or, okay, it's an Ice Punch, so kind of like that on there. We have the back-to-back Dragon Claws. Now, Poliwrath is so tanky, guys. So I need to actually use this. And we actually ended up CMPing. We CMP right here. But I totally forget that they have a Toad in the back. They're going to go ahead and throw. I'm like, dude, I was surprised. But we're still able, because they have a Mud Shot as a fast move, we're going to go ahead and resist that. And we're going to go ahead and throw this Dragon Claw, which KOs the Poliwrath. And now because they're at such low health, even if it's super effective, were able to take down the Haxors. Now, I believe this is maybe the almost close to the last match here. And this one, I almost won. But I think I did mess up here. So they're going to do Night Slash. And I'm like, okay, I for some reason thought that this scissor might have Iron Head. But it seemed like it wasn't the case. No, so now they shielded once. And I'm like, okay, this isn't too bad. I'm not shielding any of these at all. Gonna go ahead and do Earthquake. Honestly, I think my opponent messed up by even switching onto the scissor, as you'll find out. And I messed up right here. I shouldn't have shielded this. I was trying to win switch to align things. And maybe I still could have won had I done things right properly. I can reach an Earthquake even at this range. I think this is like 1 HP at this point. Right? They take us out now. Now I can align things, bring in my Charizard. And I don't know why I'm waiting for the switch clock. Maybe I'm just waiting in general. They end up bringing a Giratina. They bring in the Giratina. So that last shield is actually going to end up biting me in the butt, dude. So right here, basically, I'm just doing Leaf Blades to try and get this Giratina into Dragon Claw range. So that's all I'm going to be doing. We're just going to be going back and forth with the Shadow Sneaks or Dragon Claws, whatever they're throwing. And we're going to be going back and forth. So that's really honestly the play there. But I messed up big time. I should have just farmed down that scissor, not used that shield, farmed down that scissor, and started getting a bunch of energy on my Charizard. Now I'm going to go ahead and do Leaf Blade. And at this point, I'm like, okay, I think we're in a range where we can go ahead and Dragon Claw this Giratina. Going to do the combo play. They're going to go ahead and shield that. And now I'm going to go ahead and I think I take this move because I know it's going to be a Dragon Claw. Okay, we're going to be fine here. Now, our opponent does the biggest catch of all time. The biggest catch of all time, catches a Dragon Claw and a Cresselia. Dude, I was so bummed out. And I don't shield this. I should have shielded this big move. I think I could have won. Now that I look back at it, I could have won. They weren't going to reach it in time. I messed up big time. Now that I see it, I could have done shielded that. And dang, man. Very, 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 very badly played there. I should have been able to reach, still won that match. So very good match to my opponent. As you can see, we almost timed out there. And now this is the last and final match. This is the hardest match that I played to date, guys. I'm just kidding. They ended up quitting the match, make it easier on us. So again, guys, this team is really good. If you haven't already, try it out. Let me know how it works for you guys. And as always, I appreciate you guys watching all my videos. I'll see you guys on the next one.